everyone. I hope you're all having a wonderful week. I am having a wonderful week. We have Spirit Week at my school this week, right before Halloween. So super fun week. And I wanted to make sure to get out our devotional for this week. We are talking about how faith is knowing God is able. Now, a quick background for those of you who haven't been here before. I started off these devotions as a way to reach out to my staff and give them something that they could study every week in their own faith life. We called it our faith project. And so I decided, you know what? I might as well share it with some other people and see if anybody else can get use out of it. So if you're here because a friend shared it with you, so happy you're here and enjoy the devotion. I really wanted to start with a section from the book I'm using for this study. And the author wrote something really well, and I just wanted to go ahead and share that first. So here we go. Faith means knowing God is able to do all that he has promised. You may not understand how, you may not know where or when, it may seem utterly, completely impossible, but for all the things you do not know, for all the odds stacked against you, in faith, there's one thing you do know. God is able, and he will deliver that which he has promised to you. Now, I think that's super relatable to a lot of people. I think we all have moments where we feel like God has been guiding us in a certain direction, and we see that God promises good things for us, but we don't know how it's going to come about. We think, man, how is God going to do this? This seems like it's taking forever. It seems impossible. But in faith, we know that God will make things possible, the impossible possible. And he keeps his promises to us, and he promises good for us and working things out for our good. So we can know that those things will happen. Now, we're going to look into a section of scripture, Psalm 121, and look at specifically some of the promises that God has made to us. Here, really key in on some of those things that how he keeps us safe and things like that. I lift up my eyes to the hills. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. Now, there is a tune that is to that psalm, and I think about that when I'm reading those words. But what comfort some of those words are. He will not let your foot slip. He watches over you day and night. He will not let harm come to you. And he watches over your life now, in this present time, and forever. He is watching over you. Wow, what a promise that is, that he has made to us. Now, there were a couple other promises that you probably have thought of just when it came straight to your head. And I wrote down some of the ones that came to my mind. And now, I don't necessarily have a specific Bible passage paired with each of these, but I do know that they are promises that God has made in his word. And they're ones that jump out to my mind. We talked about he will not let us fall and that he watches over us. He provides for me. He gives me my daily bread, my things that I need every day. If we went and looked at all the things in our house, in our workplace, we would see God has provided so many things. And yet, sometimes we complain about just the few that we don't have, right? So, wow, how has God kept his promise to me? Sometimes we're like, but I really, really have been working towards this. I really wanted to pay off my car, or I wanted to get a house, or things like that, big things. But look at what God has provided. So I thought that was a good one. He protects me. He is always with me. He promises peace, joy, and love. Through my faith, I have fruits of the Spirit that produce. He promises me that he is preparing a place for me in heaven, and that when I am there, every tear will be wiped from my eyes and we will be perfect, without sin, without stain. He promises me I am his child and I will inherit the kingdom of God. He promises that my sins are forgiven, even the ones that I constantly struggle with every single day, and I ask God constantly, I'm sorry for that sin that I keep repeating. He forgives that one and all the past ones and all the future ones. They're all forgiven. And God works out all things for my good and he has a plan for me. That is a big one, to know that he has a specific plan just for me. Out of all the people in the world, he has a plan for just me as well. Now that big one, talking about our sins, right? God, right after the fall into sin, Adam and Eve fell into sin, he made a plan for salvation. He said that I will send someone to crush the devil. And he did. We see all throughout scripture how God kept that promise in the Old Testament, foreshadowing to Jesus coming. And then Jesus came. He lived a perfect life. He died. He rose again. Wow. What an amazing thing that is, that God worked all of that out. And if he can fulfill those promises about a plan for salvation, how much more can he fulfill that for me? And so this leads into our next question. As I was reading through some of those different promises, there might be one that stuck out to you. And I want you to think about, for you right now in your life, which of God's promises is most important to you? And then after you think about that, go ahead and write a prayer out, knowing the ways that God is keeping that promise in your life. I think a big one for me that sticks out to me is that God has a plan for me. He says that in Jeremiah, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." I think I'm kind of in a stage in life where there's things that are unknown. I don't know what the future holds. I don't know how God wants me to go about certain things or where things are leading. And knowing that God has a specific plan for me and it's not to harm me, it's going to be good for me, that is so reassuring. Even when in that plan, there might be something that's super hard and harmful, not harmful, but hurts. In the moment, there's things that hurt our hearts and our emotions, but then as we go forward, we see that God was guiding things. It was in his plan and we grow from them. And so we see ultimately that that was good for me, even though in the moment I didn't think it was, it ultimately was good for me in the grand scheme of things. So that gives me hope. It gives me joy, and it gives me peace knowing that as I go throughout my life, God orchestrated my plan for the plan for salvation for me and for everyone, and he did that perfectly. How much more is he gonna do that too for my life? And the plan for salvation was huge. That was big. And then for just me, he has a plan too. That's amazing. So I hope as you go throughout your week, you are reassured by that as well, that God has a specific plan for you and he is able to fulfill the promises he has made to you in the Bible. And you can go forward knowing that. Let's go ahead and end with a prayer. Dear Lord, we thank you so much that you are always with us, that you protect us and provide for us. And ultimately, we thank you for the plan of salvation that you promised and fulfilled through your Son, Jesus. We ask that you be with us as we go throughout our week. Help us to remember all the ways that you are keeping your promises to us every single day. Help us to know that you are able, and our faith can help us to remind us of that, and help us to just share that with others. In your name we pray, amen. All right, I hope you have a great rest of your week, and we'll see you next time.